Senator Grisanti to explain his vote.
I'm going to vote yes on this bill, and one thing that I want to say to my friends across the aisle who doubt UB 2020, if you want to have and sit there and denounce the commitment of your own governor, who has stated 5 times in a press conference that there will be a summit in Buffalo, you don't have to attend, that's fine. If you want to doubt what happened here in the Senate of a 55-1 vote, that's fine. But what I didn't see is I didn't see the Democrats on that side talking to their Democratic friends in the Assembly to push that bill forward, as I was doing, not only with the Republicans, but meeting with Deborah Glick and other members. This bill is not dead. This bill has moved faster in the last 90 days than it has in 3 years. When the Democrats were in the majority, the bill couldn't even pass. I've been here 90 days and this bill has gone further than ever. It is not dead. We have talked to the governor. We have commitments. There's a summit. If you want to use it for political gain, that's fine. But I've talked to the people at UB 2020 about this bill. I've talked to the tradespeople, and they are ecstatic as to where UB 2020 lays at this point in time. So if you want to have shame and shoot me down for UB 2020, go ahead. We'll see what happens at the end of session. But UB 2020 is not dead. It's alive. I know it's important in Western New York, but I'm not a one-issue person. There are other things in this bill, restoring funding to Roswell Park, that the Senate did on this side, no help from the Assembly, no help from the governor. Restoration of basically Dara Martin House, Olmsted Park, Hoyt Lake projects, restoring funding to education. These are things we did on this side. And I appreciate what the Senate did, but don't doubt my word, UB 2020 is not dead. It's alive and well. It will be voting in the affirmative.
Senator Grisanti votes in the affirmative.